mostly made of pain. He wakes up just to work and straight back home again. He once cut all my nightmares out of paper, and I thought it was so beautiful I put it on a record cover. And I tried to tell him that he had a sense of color and composition so magnificent. And he said, "Thank you, please, but your flattery is truly not becoming me. Your eyes are poor, you're blind, you see. No beauty could have come from me. I'm a waste of breath, of space, of time. I knew a woman, she was dignified and true, and her love for her man was one of her many virtues. Till one day she found out that he had lied, so she decided the rest of her life from that point on will be a lie. But she was grateful for everything that had happened, and she was anxious for all that would come next. But then she wept, what did you expect in that big old house with the car she kept? In such is life, she often said, with one day leading to the next, you'll get a little closer to your death. That was fine with her, she never got upset, and with every day she may have left, she would never clean another mess up, fold his shirts or look her best. She was free to waste away alone. Last night my brother, he got drunk and drove, and this cop, he pulled him off to the side of the road. And he said, "Officer, officer, you got the wrong man. Now I'm a student of medicine, a brother of a folk singer, you don't understand." The cop said, "No one got hurt, you should be thankful. Your carelessness, it is something awful. And no, I can't just let you go. Though your father's name is known, your decisions now, they are yours alone. You're nothing but a stepping stone on a path to death, to loss, to shame." The last few months I've been living with this couple. Oh, you know the kind who buy everything in doubles. Sure, they fit together like a puzzle. And I love their love, and I'm grateful that someone actually receives the prize that was promised. By all his fairy tales that troubled us, and they still do me. I'm sick, lonely, no laurel tree, just green envy. Will my number come up eventually, like love some kind of lottery? Will you scratch and see what's underneath? And it's sorry, just one cherry. Play it again. Get lucky. So I've been hanging out down by the train's depot. Now I don't ride there, now to sit and watch the people there. They remind me of one of cars in motion, the way they spin and turn and jockey for positions. And I wanna scream out that it all is nonsense. Hey, life's one track, Can't you see it's pointless? But just then my knees give under me. My head feels weak. Suddenly it's clear to see it's not them but me who's lost my self-identity as I hide behind these books I read while scribbling my poetry. Like art could save a wretch like me with some ideal ID. It's trite and cheap and a waste of pain, of pain, of time. So I parked my car down by the cathedral, where the floodlights point up at the steeple. Choir practice, it was filling up with people. I could hear the sound escaping as an echo, sloping off the ceiling at an angle. And when the voices blended, they sounded like angels. I hope there's some room still in the middle. But when I lift my voice up now to reach them, the range is too high way up there in heaven. And so I hold my tongue, I forget the song. I will tie my shoes and start walking off. And I try to just keep moving on with my broken heart and my absent God. But I have no faith. And